Today's episode, Blue Lake Adventure on Survivor Men. So this is the trailhead. We're ready to go. And we're going to be heading down that trail right up there. So more adventures to come. We'll be checking in all the way through this.
More adventures.
Yeah.
Adventures to come.
Through this episode. So while foraging for food, we've come upon this moist...
Streaming with fish!
We're going to harvest this skunk cabbage here, Latin name, Curvius dorsima.
Skunkus cabbages.
It's poisonous raw, but what we're going to do is smoke it over the fire tonight, 30-35 minutes, and then it tastes like hickory. So...
And you can also build a... shelter from the broad skunk cabbage leaves.
Easily.
We may do that as well. Very primitive conditions up here in wilderness, so.
We do what we can.
We'll be moving on now, heading toward our destination of Marion Lake, where we'll take a bit of nourishment if we can find more along the way. We've arrived at our first way stop on this journey. This is Lake Ann. So, and we're also crossing over the outlet to Lake Ann. And we can hear the water flowing beneath our feet. This is water that's good for drinking, good for bathing and washing things. And we will use some of it for all those purposes. And if you listen carefully, you can hear it.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Right here we have a oddly shaped fungus that grows into a very hard, shiny, metal-like material. It's bioluminescent. That's why it's pink like this.
Look at that, in the shape of a hook.
It's always in the shape of a hook. They call it hook fungus. Mm-hmm. And it's great for catching fish and using to stitch up wounds and things like that. So
when you're dropped off in the middle of the wilderness without any tools, is that a good thing to have?
This is a great thing to have. This is a very fortunate omen.
We may be able to eat dinner tonight.
Right. And luckily there's also a symbiotic organism that grows next to it. Fishing line worm likes to attach itself to the tip of the fungus and extract nutrition.
We've had an amazing bit of luck right here.
Yeah.
Let's hope it keeps up.
Very fortuitous.
We've just arrived at the Marion Creek outlet from Marion Lake and by good fortune stumbled upon a couple of rudimentary tools that may be very useful to us in our
Brian,
quest.
It appears to be an old mining camp.
It appears that we have found an old foot adze here. Well, in this case, it's actually called a hazel hoe.
Hazel hoe.
Hazel hoe, yes. You can see in the bottom of the screen here. Normally, a hazel hoe has a handle curved like this, that nice smooth S shape, while a foot adze would have one arc. Just one arc, you know? And the way this thing would work is you'd go up, I just squared this log up just to show you. You'd go up and stand with a log between you and just chisel away at it. And
it took you about five and a half minutes.
Yeah, five minutes or so. About time to resharpen, you know. But
And is it common to find these tools in nature?
Well, yeah. You know. Where there have been old mining camps, they'd be squaring up logs to support the shafts and things like that. And
It appears they were mining steel.
Yeah.
some kind of out. It comes in handy for the building of things such as bridges.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, the crystalline structure allows the steel to form into these rods, you know.
Yeah. It's naturally occurring like a quartz crystal, if you will.
Exactly.
So
at this point in our quest for survival, all is going well. We've covered approximately 2.5 miles on the trail and hoping to continue in good health and with good fortune on the rest of the trip. After a hearty lunch on the side of the trail, we finally reached our next milestone, Marion Lake, and it looks like this. A little windy out here, but otherwise a nice day. And evidence of a large forest fire on the ridges across the lake. Fire that happened 3-4 years ago.
Well, I think it was about 3 years ago now. Fire passed through this way, went on up over yon butte.
Yeah.
Yep.
Probably sending a stream of animals out in front of it, running away just like that scene in Bambi.
Tragic.
Heart-wrenching, really.
Tragic, devastating, and threatening. But we march on. We continue our trek. We're beginning to get just a bit concerned about foodstuffs out here in the devastated wilderness. The wildfire certainly diminished the wildlife potential out here. And as you can see, there's very little left of the heavily wooded landscape that used to be here. It does open up a view of Mount Jefferson off through the trees there, something that would not have been seen before the fire. We're headed on up. Trail continues up that way and is relentless, leading us closer to Blue Lake. We're considering climbing up to the top of that rock outcrop in order to scout the landscape a bit better, see if we can actually find some wildlife. If we don't, there's real concern that this evening we'll be